Hello and greetings from Iceland. As you might know already, eruption number 10 on the Reykjanes Peninsula since 2021 has just started. And what I'm going to do now is to cover what matters for the local people and for tourists, where the fire came up this time, how large the eruption is. And to make this simple, it looks right now as we got lucky. What we have is a smaller eruption than we had in last August, but it is impressive, as they always are, during the first hours. And it is not likely that it will grow any larger from now. And that is good because we have to keep in mind that we have two towns now at risk. At the southwest end of this crater row that is erupting, we have Grindavík, and at the northeast end, we have a village called Vogar, and around 1,500 people live there. And I shot this clip during the last eruption as the lava was moving toward the town. So we have been a bit worried about if this eruption or the eruptions to come might move even closer to that town due to how far north the last eruption occurred. But when we look at the fissure as it is developing tonight, the center part of it is further south than last time. And as for tourism, there are no interruptions when it comes to international flights, but the view from the airport road might look a bit unusual. The Blue Lagoon was evacuated tonight, and also Grindavík. Only around 50 people were staying there, and the evacuation operation went very well. Our rescue workers have had plenty of practice. So this evening leaves us with pretty much one more unanswered question. What about the lava that is coming up? And it is plenty of it. And since it is the middle of the night, it is hard to say exactly where. Some of the reporters out there tonight, they had no idea about the topography. So the last 2 hours here for me have been about sorting out the useful information from the useless information. And as you know, there are webcams there, but they do only so much. But I recommend the live stream that Isaac was doing tonight. He got quite close with the drone until he did the same mistake that I tend to do, or staying out for too long. So he will be looking for his drone tomorrow. But I did, however, see through his videos where the lava is running now, just about, or between those two mountains. And for a while I got a bit worried that the lava would follow the lava berm by the power plant, perhaps all the way down to the Blue Lagoon. And although there is a lava berm around it, it's still not a good feeling to have the lava flowing there, because there is also a hot water pipeline there that has been protected with gravel. But will it be enough? That is something we won't find out until we try it. But it seems to me as the lava is flowing a bit further north this time. So it is likely that we will lose even larger part of the Grindavík highway. But that is not a big deal. We have lost sections of that road before and fixed it before. It's just a road. And most importantly, it looks as no infrastructure is at serious risk right now. However, as we know from the 7 eruptions that have occurred at this location, there is still room for surprises. Perhaps a long-lasting eruption, but the most likely scenario is that this will be over for the most part tomorrow. There will be some craters that will live on for some days, perhaps 2 or 3 weeks, but for the most part, this will be over tomorrow. And it would not surprise me if it would be business as usual in the Blue Lagoon in a couple of days, because we know pretty well what we are dealing with around here, and we have seen that happen before, that the Blue Lagoon opens up even before the eruption is over. So I think they will open up very soon if this develops, as I think as this will develop. But the timing was, however, a surprise. I was expecting this eruption to occur on December 1st and even getting ready to change my mind and expect it around Christmas. So it was a surprise when it started today. I did, however, notice several strong earthquakes on the Reykjanes Ridge before this development started, but I never expected the eruption to take place tonight, or only one day after we could see some serious change in the seismic activity. So there are always some changes between eruptions, and each and every eruption leaves plenty of data for scientists to work with. And all we can do now is to hope that this lava that is coming up tonight will find itself a good storage space so we can get back to business, open up Grindavík again and the Blue Lagoon, knowing that we will get a few months break now from all this. And this timing might perhaps allow some of the people that used to live in Grindavík to return to town to stay there over the Christmas. So this timing is not bad at all. This eruption would have been way larger if it would have occurred late December, as the Met Office was already expecting. And while I got this news tonight, my first thought was to drive the 450 kilometers to the Reykjanes Peninsula after loading my camera stuff in the car. But I have to admit that it is not a good idea to drive those snowy mountains in the middle of the night. So right now I'm not sure how I will go about this. And like my subscribers may have noticed, I've not been much around on the channel the last 2 weeks, although I have been working a lot in video processing, and I was just about to finish a video about the village Vogar just by this eruption. And that video is a part of my town series, and the original idea was to get it online before this eruption that started tonight. But that is obviously too late now. And that video is also a part of my information package about the Reykjanes Peninsula. And since the eruption came up so early, it's just a good thing since I need to adapt the final version to this new reality on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And as for my trip, I am going to think things over after this upload, see how this develops, if the trip would be worth the effort, and of course make a new update tomorrow after I see where the lava will be going or not. And finally, I'm leaving links to some of the webcams I've found and Icelandic news, where there are photos to be found, and the usual links to news in English. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.